आई डोंट वेस्ट, जो आरओ वाटर है मेरे घर में कभी वेस्टेज होता ही नहीं.
अराउंड 3 इयर्स आई हैव स्टॉप शॉपिंग एट ऑल.
सो द नेक्स्ट सेशन इज एन ओपन हाउस डिस्कशन वेयर इन Robin Sarkar, who is project director, Shiv Nadar Foundation, my friend in here. He's joining us. He'll be moderating with me. So we want you all to engage. Probably we can just start be in a round circle position in here and start talking about small steps that you all take in your daily lives to do your bit for the environment. It could be anything. It could be just not buying plastic bottles. It could be taking your shopping bag to the market and also encouraging people to do that. And the idea of this session, this small session, asking all of you engaging in these conversations is to amplify what you do, because you have the camera rolling in here, you have the power of social media now. Individual who's taking decisions at some large corporation or individual who's making some decisions at a large foundation, if he's doing something interesting, it might encourage somebody to do that. We just put out a thought in there. We just put out a video, a message from you in the social media or through Cause Because newsletters and magazines and reach out to more individuals.
Thank you very much. I'll start with my journey also. It's been around 3 years. I've stopped shopping at all. I've taken one thing that I will only shop if I need something. So that is something which I have taken up as my practice. Of course, not using single-use plastic is one of the things. And believe me, I need to get the sabji wala convinced that mereko ye polythene nahi chahiye jo tum dene wale ho. And even to the extent, sometimes if I don't have a bag, I carry things in my pockets around my arms, but I do not use single plastic. That's one of the things which I do.
So on a very small note, our organization is converting parali into manure, and it is also converting it into pots. So, and we plant a little sapling and gift it to people. So it's on a very, very small thing. It has yet to be recognized by people like you present here, but we are at it.
Parali has a quality of absorbing water in itself. So you needn't water your plants daily. Even in peak summers, you can skip a day. So we are kind of preserving or conserving water. That is one thing we are doing. And at a very small scale and the word of mouth, I mean, people come and buy it from us. The second thing I'm going to share it with you is we get those pannies. What do you do with those pannies? Usme kooda dal ke phenk dete hain. We have these two, three ladies. What they do with those pannies, they cut them into strips. And a kiroshya, mota kiroshya leke, they weave it into chattais and they distribute it to all those people who are in winters who are lying outside AIIMS. So that's what we are doing. And in our market, in our colony, both in Sarojini Nagar and Green Park, me and my husband are known for that. Oh, ye madam aagi hai, abhi panni nahi legi aur panni ke upar bhashan dengi. So that's what, I mean, a little way we are doing something about. I mean, we are passionate about preserving this environment, but we would need help from people, researchers who are doing some kind of research on what can be done. This we are doing as layperson.
Recycling and reusing. So the only thing that it's not environment friendly in this room is this flex here.
Yeah.
And there is one standee outside. And I have a good old friend here who's from Rohit Sharma. So what he does is, he takes these standees, this flex, from all the hoardings that corporates are putting around D&T flyover, Gurgaon flyover, he converts them into bags, and these bags are being used. Oh, you have your bags there, no?
Yeah,
probably you can just talk about your initiative yourself and we can show us the bags.
Hi everyone. So the whole idea was that, you know, once the flex is taken off, it heads for a landfill somewhere or other, or maybe used by, you know, these, you know, at construction sites. So the thought came that why not, you know, because flex is such a durable material, it is waterproof, it's in all kind of weather, and obviously the main reason is that it's, you know, kind of, I won't call it recycling, this is, you know, upcycling. So like to, you know, like this backpack, unfortunately only part of it could be made of flex, but, you know, I'm in conversation with a few corporates, and I would really appreciate help from people around here. I'm in conversation with HDFC, and you know, they use a lot of flex, not as, you know, as hoarding, but in, you know, at their all the banks. So what we came up with is that how can it be used? So they are sending out close to 6 lakh or 7 lakh checks every year. So we thought, why not, you know, get it at one place and reuse it to make checkbook envelopes or maybe, you know, statement sleeve and things like this. Besides this, I am doing, you know, as a retail, I'm doing tote bags for women. There are lunch boxes, there are laptop sleeves, which look really classy.
Diwali, मैंने और मेरी वाइफ ने completely zero waste Diwali बनवाई, because no कोई भी ऐसा ingredient हमने use नहीं किया जो eco friendly नहीं था.
I don't waste जो RO water है मेरे घर में कभी waste नहीं होता ही. So being a engineering background, मतलब एक engineer हूँ तो कुछ ना कुछ दिमाग में चलता रहता है. Everybody knows कि RO हम use करते हैं और उसका पानी wastage होता ही है. So I have done something differently. But I have put one tank, a little bit upside. जो wastage होता है उस tank में मैंने डाल दिया. उस tank से आपने देखा होगा जो नीचे की तरफ एक नल होता है उसको मैंने एक पाइप से जोड़ दिया. हमारा जो वॉश मशीन यूज़ करते हैं, वाइफ यूज़ करते हैं जस्ट पॉट्स वॉश करने के लिए, वहीं पे पानी का रख दिया मैंने, बांध दिया उसको. और उसके ऊपर एक तार से मैंने एक चीज़ बांध दी. जब उसको ऑन करना होता है वो ऑन कर देती है, तो जितना भी पानी होता है वो मैं रीयूज़ करता हूँ. आई डोंट वेस्ट, जो आर ओ वाटर है मेरे घर में कभी वेस्टेज होता ही नहीं. सो एक और फिर एक मॉडल, मतलब एक जस्ट डायग्राम बना के भी मैंने अपने ट्विटर हैंडल पे डाला था. कुछ लोगों ने फॉलो भी किया, काफ़ी लोगों ने अप्रिशिएट भी किया था.
सो वी ऑल टेंड टू ऑर्डर इन फूड और हैव स्टफ कमिंग इन एट होम. आई टेंड टू रिसाइकल वट एवर कंटेनर कम्स इन बाई मेकिंग इट ईदर अ प्लांटर और समथिंग. द अदर थिंग दैट वी आई हैव डन इज इवन वेस्ट लाइट्स दैट आई हैव विच हैव बीन डिस्कार्डेड आउट ऑफ माई हाउस. I've tried to make tables or chairs by just getting them welded and aligned together so that I'm not putting anything in the recycle.
हमारे यहाँ पे जो काम करने वाले आती है उसको हम लोगों ने पहले से ही ऑब्जर्व किया कि वो करती क्या है और फिर वो कैसे पानी बर्बाद कर रही है, कैसे पानी यूज कर रही है. क्योंकि हम लोग, मैं पहले रहा गुजरात में, बाद में राजस्थान में, तो पानी की कीमत आपको पता है कि वहाँ के लोगों को ज़्यादा पता है. तो हमारे घर में भी वाइफ जो है वो उसको वो सिखाए कि भाई देखो इसको हम लोग कैसे कर सकते. तो जो आपने बताया वो सिंपल उसका फॉर्मूला है. जो वेस्ट वाटर निकलती है वो गमले में वो कलेक्ट करती है और वो जितना पानी जो वॉश करते हैं, जो पहली बार बर्तन धोने के समय वो हमारे जो घर में काम करने हैं तो उसको सिखाया और वो पिछले 11 साल से हमारे यहाँ काम कर रही है. वो आज तक वो उसको फॉलो कर रही है और वो जो काम करने वाली है उसने कम से कम हमारे सोसाइटी में वो 6 या 7 घर में काम करती है, वो उसने सारे घरों में उसको इम्प्लीमेंट करा दिया. वो इम्पोर्टेंट है कि आप खुद ना करें सिर्फ, लेकिन आपके थ्रू कोई और भी सीखता है वो भी बाकी जगह कर सकते हैं.
फर्स्ट एट आवर हाउस दिस समर वी डिडंट यूज एसीज एंड वी हैड अ लिटिल अनकंफर्ट फॉर लास्ट फर्स्ट 1 वीक, बट देन वी गॉट यूज्ड टू इट. सो वी यूज टू कीप आवर जो हमारी खिड़कियाँ हमेशा बंद रहती थी, वी ओपन डैम एंड वी हैड ए ब्यूटिफुल समर दिस टाइम. उससे 2 फायदे हुए. एक तो हमारा बिजली का बिल भी कम हो गया, विच यूज टू कम अराउंड 8,000, इट स्टार्टेड कमिंग अराउंड 2,000-1,000 सामने. वैसे भी दिल्ली में वो शुरू में फ्री देते हैं 300 यूनिट्स, वी कुड नॉट कम टू दैट लेवल, बट एटलीस्ट वी कुड रिड्यूस आवर बिल. सेकेंड थिंग, वॉट एवर मॉर्निंग वी हैव स्टार्टेड गोइंग नाउ फॉर, क्योंकि विद एज दिस है कि हेल्थ इज द फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी, तो वी हैव स्टार्टेड गोइंग फॉर वॉक इन द मॉर्निंग. तो हमने क्या किया, जो हमारा पार्क है जहाँ पे हम घूमने जाते हैं, वी हैव मेड ए ग्रुप. तो जितने भी, मोस्ट ऑफ देम देयर आर लॉट ऑफ यंग पीपल ऑल्सो देयर, बट मोस्टली द एल्डर वंस. तो हम संडे को जो है एक बड़ा सा बैग ले जाते हैं, सभी को देते हैं, एंड वी कलेक्ट ऑल द प्लास्टिक एंड ऑल इन द पार्क देयर एंड गिव इट टू म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन. सो वी हैव लिंक्ड इट विद म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन, सो एज दे प्रोसेस इट, दे हैव ए प्लांट एक्चुअली. तो इट्स वर्किंग वेरी वेल. और उससे 2 फायदे हुए, एक तो प्लास्टिक का हुआ और दूसरा अब एटलीस्ट आई नो 50% पीपल इन माई कॉलोनी, जबकि पहले मैं एक को भी नहीं जानता था उससे पहले. नाउ एटलीस्ट 50% से गुड मॉर्निंग. थैंक यू.
Foundation. We have been doing plantations in many corner of the city, Delhi. We have been doing plantations many times. We have done.
After working in Delhi for 18 long years, publishing some scientific reports, some 30, you know, journal papers, what I realize is that it's still not reaching the masses. And Professor Viswas rightly yes. said that it has to reach the at the community yes. scale. So I started getting into, you know, spending some time into the creative fields. We came up with a musical band, and there's a song on air pollution, which we wrote and put it on the YouTube. It's called Ruk Jao. I don't know, you may have heard it. It has got some decent number of hits. And then I also started this, you know, just to interact more with children on these issues. This video cartoon called Pavni, mm-hmm. the Vayu Warrior. Mm-hmm. That's something just to, you know, bring this sensitization in the minds of the children. That's my few cents.
Very, very, very.
As children, they have this curious nature. So this question that I, you know, often from my little cousin that I always got asked for anything was, where does this come from? Where does this come from? And that's something that I sort of implemented in my own life. And as Ruchi, if I'm not wrong, Ruchi just said that as youth, we are very suspicious of everything that the government is telling us, you know, and that the companies are telling us. So this little young cousin of mine who kept asking me, whenever we used to go to the grocery store, we used to buy something, anything, she constantly used to ask me, where does this come from? Where does this come from? And that has now evolved into this entire practice where whenever I'm buying something, I'm consciously asking myself, where does this come from? Because companies, a lot of companies are actually greenwashing a lot of things that, you know, on the packaging it says that it's environment friendly, it's sustainable, but it's actually not. So a simple act of just Googling the entire manufacturing process, and not just in terms of environment, but also the labor that's gone into making it, the conditions of that labor. So that's just one thing that I always...
I think we all have to be very conscious, like, what are we buying? Are we buying apples from United States? Or are we buying apples from India? Are we buying cheese from France? Or are we buying cheese from India? I mean, there's no need to buy all these products that have been traveling all over the world, because in that way we can definitely save environment. So that's something we all can do. Thank you.